Hello everyone, in this video I will talk about the put sell strategy for ECB stock, which has been very volatile, and most of its life in like last 2 years it has been continuously falling more or less, and hopefully it has stabilized it now. And the reason I say it has a little bit stabilized has to do with its annual revenue and its valuation, which is very close to 1:3 ratio that I typically make. And now onwards I believe that the stock could have this sales finally growing, albeit a little bit slow, and that's why its valuation is okay for now. Currently it's trading at $10.50 as of on August 4, 2020. And then that brings us to the next question: what is my strategy for ECB, and then in terms of getting into it at this point of time? So I will bring about two strategies for ECB. The first strategy I will call it as buying at dips, which typically means that, and I have another generic video about it, about buying at dips strategy. So what you do is, let's say you keep around $10,000 to $12,000 of money aside for ECB stock, and what you do is you buy one stock now at $10.50, and let's say it goes down by, let's say, 10%, which will be roughly like $9.50. You buy 200 stocks of ECB again, and you bring your average point not to the halfway between 9.10 and 10.5, which is 10, but less than 10, more like 9.75 or so. I do not have a calculator to calculate those things. And let's say it goes down further to 8.5, then you buy 300 stocks of ACB, and so on and so forth, all the way until to about like 6.5 or so, or maybe 6. So there, where at that point there is some chance that this company may go bankrupt, and if you want to pay a little bit scrape, you can do, what you could do is wait for like 20% down instead of 10.5 to 9.5. You can wait to 20% down roughly at 8.5 before increasing your quantity. So personally, I believe that it, because it looks like it's close to its bottom, I believe that buying at 10% decline makes more sense. So that's my feeling, but you can, depending upon your risk aversion and your capacity to take up the risk, you can buy more at lower dips. So that's one strategy, but the key strategy that I want to talk about is the put sell strategy. Basically that means that at 10.50 you do not buy any stock of ACB at all, but instead you put sell at $10 strike price. What does that mean is you plan to buy the stock at $10 at a future price that I call, and if you don't know about the put sell strategy, you plan to buy it at $10 at a future date, let's say August 14, if the share dips down $10. And then there is a premium for that. That premium you get paid because you are selling the put. So at 14th August, only two things can happen: the stock price keeps above $10, or the stock price goes down $10. Or the third thing you could see that it keeps increasing above 10.5, which is same as it's staying above $10 from the perspective of what actually happened. So if the stock is $10 or above, you get the premium, which will be typically like 30 cents or 25 cents or whatever. So in 2 weeks of time, you get those 20 or 30 cents, and let's say 30 cents, then that is 3% of money in 2 weeks, which is still like 1.5% per week, which is a good money. And then if you, the price gets lower than like $10, you get that the stock assigned, which is better than what you could have been buying directly at $10.50. So the effective price, if the premium is 30 cents, would actually be $10.20, because for $10.50 is the price you also get the premium. So your effective price is $10.30, and let's say on that date actually $9.80, your effective price is $9.80, sorry about that. And let's say at that point the stock price goes further down than $9.80, let's say $9.50, then what you could do is you again put sell at that point of time. At this time you will put the strike price at something like $9, and then you will either collect premium or you will get assigned the more share, and you average down your price further. So this is the strategy that I use for the stocks like ACB. I have been doing it. I actually am worse, because I had some ACB stocks assigned at $13, and I did a put sell when the stock suddenly rose to like $18 and $19, and then it fell down to $15. At that point of time I did a put sell and I got some shares assigned at $13 or $14. So I am at some loss at this point of time, and for which what I am doing is I am doing another strategy, which is called a call sell strategy, which is means that I would sell the cross stock if it reaches something like $13 or $14, and if it does not reach, I will I will keep the premium. So I believe that buying at dips, and then the buying at dips could be dangerous, because if you look at the ACB's historical prices, at some point of time, and I'm talking about the current after 12:1 split, at some point of time it was like $80-$90, and it's currently $10. So just mentally imagine if you would have started buying this share at $70 or $60, then your share prices could keep falling and you could keep buying, and then your losses would have been phenomenal. But at $70-$80, the valuation was not very favorable. The stock was trading at a much much higher price compared to its any proven sale, and that there was some inherent risk into that. And hopefully with some sale numbers now stabilized, I think that's a right time to buy this stock. I hope my video is going to help you make your own strategy for the ACB stock. Thanks for taking a look.